Well, good morning, everybody. Good morning again to anyone at the circuit listening to us. But good morning for the first time for our international audience around the world watching on YouTube and Facebook. Welcome to the 2021 Rock Cup Superfinal. Day four of the competition here at South Garda Karting in Lonato. And it's the big one, finals day, where we're going to crown our champions across all of our categories. My name is Andrew Mather. Alongside me in the commentary box once again is the brilliant, the wonderful, the majestic Daniele Lasmina. Daniele, we're finally here. It's been a long, long 3 days of competition proceeding to this, but we're going to kick things off with our Senior Rock OMP Trophy Final. This should be a good one.
Yeah, this is the place to be. Of course, thank you for all the wonderful words for me, and I have to thank Double Dash Motorsport Media to always send me the best member of the team, so I could work with him. Of course, this is the place to be, this is the time of the year we prefer, and this is the race that we want to see. Now we start with the trophy, then the super finals, so siamo pronti, benvenuti a tutti. Daniele Lasmina qui con Andrew Mather di Double Dash Motorsport Media e siamo pronti a raccontarvi le super final della Rock Cup 2021. È il momento che stavamo aspettando forse da tutto l'anno. I grossi premi in palio, ci saranno le premiazioni dopo, ma per arrivare al momento clou, ovviamente i trofei in mattinata e poi nel pomeriggio le finali di ogni categoria. Partiamo da loro, partiamo dai senior, dalla Senior Rock, che mette in palio ora l'OMP Trophy.
Let's have a look through the grid then for this OMP Trophy race. Rodrigo Pavez from Chile starts on pole position. Federico Biagioli starts alongside him on the front row. Andrew Machel and Mattia Chiarato start on row two. Michal Bartosz and David Marcinowski start on row three. Jose Andres Cordova Belduma starts on row four alongside Dennis Andrew Boricianu. Row five has Enzo Montecinos and Yuri Nemechek. On its row six, Maria Augustina Herrera-Oard and Fabian Boffel. We're just going to check if we are good to go for this 15-lap race. No, we're going to go around again. Good, we can continue with the grid. Row 7 has Lorenzo Balandi and Leonardo Meña on it. We'll talk about Meña in a moment. Alfredo Cizzoni and Sebastian Blanco on row 8. Pietra Pliska and Rebecca Guagliolini are on row number 9. Row 10 has Giuseppe Bitti on it and Tim Meidel. And all Great Britain, row 11, with Max Davies and Daniel Pepper. Richard Seifert from Germany starts alongside Gabriele Cucinotta on row 12. And Yarden Ovid from Israel starts alongside Daniel Lischak on row 13. Paul Koch and Miguel Canones on row 14. Isaac Lord and Lucas Pache form out the 30-cart field for this one. 15 laps for this Senior Rock OMP Trophy race. All of these drivers looking to finish off well, and in particular Leonardo Meña. We mentioned him because he's been one of the fastest drivers in the competition so far, but he's in this race because he's not had a good time in the heats.
E vedremo allora chi si porterà a casa questo trofeo MP in questa Senior Rock. Come detto, Pavez e Biagioli a partire dalla prima fila. Lo citavi tu, Andrew Meña, è stato molto veloce tutto il weekend, ma molto sfortunato. E semaforo verde, si parte.
Off we go then, diving into turn one, then the triple run to turn four, two, three, and then turn four, going round the right-handers, looking pretty okay at the moment. And just as I say that, there's an incident in the middle of the field, and someone's already off towards the back of the order through hairpin number one, also known as turn five. And there's more chaos there, and there's damage to some carts as well. One, two, three, four carts involved. Bit of a messy start here in the OMP Trophy race.
Okay, it's 2021 that get away with it. Or maybe 211, I don't know.
Daniel Pepper's involved, not come through sector one. Richard Seifert and Yarden Ovid as well. So all of their races are over. The 2-3-4 I can see in front of us here in the commentary box is out of the race. It's Balandi. Lorenzo Balandi is out of this one. So end of lap number one. It's Pavez from Machel leading this race. Chiarato there in third race. Biagioli down to fourth. And Marcinowski in the top five as well.
E allora Pavez a guidare davanti a Marcel Chiarato, Biagioli, Marcinowski, poi Cordova, Nemechek, Montecinos e Bartosiuk con Leonardo Meña in chiusura di top 10. fuori al primissimo giro, credo sia stato sia uscito anche Richard Seift, poi Max Davis e Bellandi che sono usciti, no, Richard Seift e Pepper non sono partiti, però insomma abbiamo visto qualche salto anche pericoloso, qualcuno è ripartito al fondo, penso a Max Davis, penso a Jared Oved che adesso stanno recuperando, e arriva Meatball Flag.
The Meatball Flag is out. That is a mechanical issue for Bitty. The number 253 will have to pull into the pits and retire. There is a safety issue on that cart, either to himself or other drivers. And yeah. Well, that will be the
probably
end of his race.
Probably was involved in one of those crash
yeah.
at the start of the first lap. Bitty allora che deve rientrare in pit lane, technical flag al suo indirizzo, lo fa in questo momento e quindi purtroppo è costretto anche lui al ritiro, probabilmente con molti, uno dei primi, dei primissimi contatti a inizio gara. Intanto la corsa prosegue con grande bagarre nel gruppo alle spalle di Curato e Marcinowski e di Maciel e Pavez che stanno conducendo la gara.
Yeah, that was Leonardo Meña making his way through the field. As I say, he's had a lot of bad luck in the heat so far, hence why he's in this race and not where we'd perhaps expect him to be in the super final later today. But he is going to give it everything to try and win this race, and it's up to P6.
Yeah. Good race start for Leonardo Meña, but we could expect that, as we were saying. Una gran partenza da parte di Leonardo Meña che scavalca un'altra posizione, sta risalendo. La china ce lo aspettavamo, come detto ha già recuperato 8 posizioni ed era stato uno dei più veloci, anche se è spesso sfortunato, forse un po' troppo irruente in alcune occasioni, mentre lì davanti provano a fare l'andatura Rodrigo Pavés il cileno con Andrew Maciel il canadese, 1 secondo e 3 di vantaggio nei confronti di Mattia Curato e David Marcinowski allo scorso rilevamento cronometrico. Vediamo al passaggio sul traguardo se questo distacco è aumentato, no, è diminuito. Curato e Marcinowski leggermente più veloci, Meña che infilando il sorpassa Biagioli fa 48,8, il primo a scendere sotto il muro dei 49 secondi in questa gara, gli altri sono tutti lontani, un altro mestiere.
On to lap 5 then, we're a third of the way through this race. Still Rodrigo Pavés from Chile leading this race ahead of Canada's Andrew Maciel. I think Giuseppe Bitty has now come into the pits to serve that mechanical flag.
Meña now attacking for the fourth position. Meña, he's there and he got it.
Yep, Meña up to fourth place and battling now between the two leaders. A little bit of contact between Pavés and Maciel there. Onto the back straight, but look in the background. There it is, Sankey Motorsport in the blue and yellow. Cart number 207, Leonardo Meña is on the move.
E allora Pavés, Maciel, Curato e adesso Meña che è arrivato ancora una volta una tornata sotto il muro dei 49 secondi, ancora una volta l'unico a saperci scendere. E qui Pavés e Maciel che hanno dato fuoco alle polveri e iniziano anche loro la danza per il primo posto, mentre dietro qua vediamo in uscita dalla tornata della 5 grande bagarre, li vediamo passare adesso alla variante sotto la nostra postazione, sempre al comando Pavés, poi Maciel, Curato, Meña che adesso attacca Curato e si prende la terza posizione d'autorità. Grande attacco di Meña che sta davvero facendo il bello e il cattivo tempo.
Meña up to third place, also keep an eye on Sebastian Blanco from Colombia, is up 8 positions to 8th place. It's a long race, he's still got time to get up there onto the podium. We're on lap 6, in fact Blanco is now into 7th place. Pavés still ahead of Maciel. Coming down into turn 5 now is Meña looking for the move. He's just holding there, but he's got so much more pace than any of the other drivers. Down the inside goes Meña for second place. That is a textbook overtake into turn 6. This is brilliant stuff from Meña.
Meña, last lap was 1 second faster than anybody else on the track, and he's got also an overtook con Curato. So he's literally flying around this Lonato track here on South Garda Cutting, and now Meña is for ready to take the lead. Vediamo se Meña si prende il comando dell'operazione a breve. Ha superato anche Andrew Maciel, adesso si è stato in seconda posizione. Pavés, Meña, Maciel, Curato, Marcinowski, Biagioli, Blanco che sta recuperando tanto a sua volta, settimo dopo che era partito 9 posizioni più in là dalla ottava fila. Vediamo adesso Meña sempre più vicino, prende la scia, il sorpasso ed è ineluttabile. Meña al comando delle operazioni, metà gara, adesso la risposta però di Rodrigo Pavés che non ci sta, ma Meña tiene l'interno e gira davanti a tutti alla curva 6.
Well, there it is. Menya to the lead of the race, then down the inside is looking Matchell, and there's a bit of contact between Matchell and Pavez there. Could have been a bit of an accident. And I think Matchell's got issues. I think Matchell's got technical issues. Yeah. He's pulled off, he's out of the race, and that is the end of Rock Cup Superfinal for 2021 for Canada's Andrew Matchell. What a shame.
Yeah, what a shame. He got simply straight, he couldn't turn, of course, and he was out of the race. Quindi fuori dai giochi Andrew Matchell, è andato semplicemente dritto al primo tornante del pettine, non è riuscito a girare il volante, evidentemente qualche problema sul suo kart. Mentre continua la lotta dietro, è arrivato Blanco che va ad attaccare Biagioli, grande rimonta anche di Sebastian Blanco che ha recuperato già 12 posizioni, mentre Menya lì davanti prova già la fuga.
Yeah, Blanco is really coming into this now. Another driver that on pure pace we would have expected at the start of the week to be in the super final.
Here is Blanco.
Been so competitive throughout the whole week, and he has been here in the OMP trophy race. Menya is just checking out now. It's got out ahead of the rest of the field. The gap is now 1.44 seconds. Pavez with good pace though. Purple in sector number three.
Menya, Pavez, Chiurato, Blanco, Biagioli, Montesinos, Marcinowski, Nemecek, Cordova e Bartosiuk a completare la top 10. Anche un'altra grande prova nel corso di queste giornate, quella di Maria Herrera, che sta chiudendo in undicesima posizione. E ora Blanco sembra fare quello che ha fatto prima Menya, sta recuperando senza possibilità di replica per gli altri.
Sebastian Blanco from Colombia down the inside then of Chiarato, up to third place now. We'll set his sights on fellow South American Rodrigo Pavez in second place. End of lap number 10 then. Five laps to go for Leonardo Menya.
And Blanco seems like Menya just some lap before,
yep,
like he's so much faster than anybody else.
And I think the key as well, you know, that first third of the race where he's been able to pull his way through the order. Blanco on sheer pace is pretty similar.
Are.
Down the inside, takes second place now, does the Colombian. But the crucial thing is, Menya was able to get through that traffic a lot quicker and clean as well. And this is where, you know, he uses that advantage now. It's going to be very difficult for Blanco to close down such a gap with only 4.5 laps to go.
Look how fast Menya still is, 48.392. A great lap once again, the fastest of course. And Menya sta guidando le operazioni, 48 e mezzo nella scorsa tornata con 48.392, il giro record dei due giri fa. Restano lui, Blanco e Nemecek praticamente, che sono stati in grado di girare nelle ultime tornate sotto il muro dei 49 secondi. Nemecek che però naviga in ottava posizione e adesso Blanco prova a mettersi all'inseguimento di Menya. 2 secondi e mezzo, potrebbe essere tardi con 3 giri e mezzo al termine. Blanco could have the peace to fight against Menya, but 2.5 seconds down, yep, could be too much.
Yeah, I think it's just going to be too much for Blanco to close in. Coming up after this, we've got the Junior Rock Levanto trophy race, and then the final race of this morning session, the Mini Rock Vortex trophy, starting at 1:30 local time. It's 2 hours away from now. We'll then start with our superfinals, Mini Rock, Junior Rock, Expert and Expert Plus, followed by Super Shifter.
Whoa!
And Senior, as it is an incident on the back straight. I can see out the window Daniele. Let's check out who it is out there. That looks quite a high speed incident.
Yeah, there was I don't know if there was a contact, but one of the cars went just too far, just took the grass and then of course the sand and was right out of the game.
Yeah, it's none of our.
I guess it's Cucinotta.
It's Cucinotta, so yeah, Gabriele Cucinotta out of the race as well. Three more laps to go, including the one that we are on. Leonardo Menya continues to lead by 2.8 seconds ahead of Sebastian Blanco, who is 0.8 of a second clear of Rodrigo Pavez.
Allora, Cucinotta fuori dai giochi con quel testacoda nella sabbia. E Menya e Blanco che adesso guidano con Blanco che sta facendo la stessa cosa di Megna, con un paio di giri di ritardo. Adesso sta prendendo un concreto vantaggio su Rodrigo Pavés e rapidamente in un due giri ha già accumulato un secondo e due di vantaggio. Resta però fisso a 2 secondi e 7 lo svantaggio da Megna, un po' perché forse il colombiano si rende conto che non può andare a prendere, un po' perché stanno girando semplicemente sullo stesso ritmo della 48 e 8. Al terzo posto in questo momento Rodrigo Pavés, che deve guardarsi alle spalle da Federico Biaccioli, Enzo Montesinos e Mattia Chiurato, tutti molto vicini insieme a David Marcinowski. Sta arrivando anche Jerin Emecek per la terza posizione. Potrebbe essere interessante vedere cosa succederà.
Biaggioli down the inside of Pavés, we just saw there, went for third place. We'll confirm if he got it. Yes, he did get it. So Biaggioli up to third place. On to the final lap then here in the Senior Rock OMP Trophy race. Leonardo Megna is now 2.9 seconds clear of Sebastian Blanco, who's 2.6 clear of this battle for third. So this is why it's so fierce, because this is over the last spot on the major podium. And down the inside there went Marcinowski. Nemechek is in there as well. That's all played into the hands though of Biaggioli, because it's given him a bit of breathing space as they go through sector number two. There he is in the yellow and black carts, running for PCR factory team here this year. But Leonardo Megna and Sankey Motorsport, they've had a very difficult week, but they're going to finish it on a high here in the Senior Rock OMP Trophy race. Leonardo Megna takes the race victory in the OMP Trophy race after 15 laps. Sebastian Blanco in second place, third for Federico Biaggioli, Yuri Nemechek in fourth, fifth place for David Marcinowski, and then Mattia Chiarato in sixth. Cordova, Herrera, Pavés, Bartichuk and Ciccone take us down to 10th place. Boricanu, Pliska, Boffel, Guagliolini in 15th. Montecinos in the end would have hoped for a little bit more, but finishes 16th in that race. And then Paul Koch, Daniel Litschak, Tim Meidel and Miguel Quinones takes us down to 20th place. And Yarden, Oved, Isaac Lord and Lucas Pache, the last of those finishers, and a number of retirements there. Cucinotta, Machel, Bissi, Davies, Balandi, Pepper and Seifert. Good
grande,
race that to kick things off for the live stream.
Grande, grande vittoria di Leonardo Megna, sì, assolutamente. Un ottimo modo di iniziare. E insomma, l'abbiamo detto un po' per tutto il weekend. È stato un po' sfortunato Leonardo Megna, forse non è riuscito a passare il taglio per le Superfinal, ma si è assolutamente rifatto con questo trofeo MP conquistato d'autorità in questa prima gara della Senior Rock di questa giornata. Una grandissima prova da parte di Megna, secondo Sebastian Blanco, anche lui autore di una rimonta straordinaria, facendo vedere che aveva il passo dei migliori. Chiude il podio Federico Biaggioli, solido, costante durante tutto il weekend, si toglie la soddisfazione del podio. Menzione d'onore per il quarto posto di Jerin Nemechek, che alla fine ha tirato su un'ottima gara ed è andato vicino ai 3 gradini del podio.
There we go, that is your OMP Trophy race completed for the 2021 Rock Cup Superfinal. If you've joined us and you don't mind sharing the stream out there on your various social medias, that'd be absolutely fantastic. Let folks know that we're racing here today. Next up out on circuit in a short few moments' time will be the second race of our trophy races. It'll be the Junior Rock Levanto Trophy. That's next up. Let's have a look at some of the highlights then from the Senior Rock OMP Trophy race. It's an interesting start with a number of carts being involved in incidents on the first lap. It's a good start from our pulses, and there we go, we see a couple of carts off towards the back of the field. A lot of drivers in this race going for broke, trying to pull their way through the order, but Rodrigo Pavés led it from the early stages, being chased by Andrew Machel from Canada. But even on lap one, we saw started to see the progress of Juan Leonardo Meña. Top two trying to lead this one out, trying to work together, and did a pretty good job of it in the early stages. The 250 of Mattia Chiarato holding third place in the first third of the race as well. Matchell was looking for a way through past Pavez as the pressure started to build and those drivers with faster pace started to come through the field. And here was Meña on the scene, going down the inside, had worked his way up from the seventh row of the grid, took the lead with some expert overtaking and never really looked back from this point in the race. Used that pace that we've seen throughout the weekend, clear of the rest of the field, to put himself in a very commanding position moving towards the trophy final race. There's still plenty of battles going on behind though, and spots on the podium to be decided. And we saw Andrew Matchell fall out of it, and also coming through the field also from the eighth row of the grid, Sebastian Blanco from Colombia. It was a very good race for the South American nations. Meña continued to lead out. This was a great move from the 265 of Federico Viaggioli. Had a not great start, had to fight back, and that was the move for third place. Yuri Nemechek was getting involved as well towards the end of proceedings, but in the end it was a comfortable victory for Leonardo Meña, who finishes his 2021 Rock Cup Superfinal in a positive fashion, winning there the Senior Rock OMP Trophy race.